Siemanko, jestem Marek i witam was w kolejnym odcinku Mafii 3. Jeśli się film będzie podobać, nie zapomnijcie zostawić lajka pod filmem. No to jedziemy.
Motherfuckers better save some for me! He's run dry!
Taking a shot!
Mama's boy!
God damn, that felt good!
I'll
be over here!
I can't move! I'm stuck here, boys!
Just learn to shoot last, that cocksucker! Can't do shit! Long live DC, motherfucker!
Back on solid ground, they don't know what to
Have a Molotov, you dumb fucker!
I see him!
Right,
I found him! Come on!
So why don't you sit for a spell and have a listen to my tale about that devil beast known as the Lugaroo?
Think I'm gonna just hand this shit over?
It all began in a small Negro village nestled deep in the bayou, far outside of the civilized city. It was a place where slaves ran out from the world. But those days brought the Negro folk closer to God, saved many a soul from the lake of fire than it did. But they started backsliding, returning to the ways of their African ancestors. And an elder named Papa Virgil led them back to that old heathen practice known as
and ye shall find.
Slide on that motherfucker out of here.
Ci sento far di
boy, you think you can come in here and steal my heroin without nobody noticing?
I'm not here to steal your heroin, Richie. I'm here to make you pay for what you did to Sammy and Ellis Robinson.
I didn't have nothing to do with it!
I watched you stab Ellis in the gut. I couldn't do nothing about it then, but I sure as hell can now.
God damn it! None of that was my idea, you hear? It was all Georgie, him and his old man. They wanted y'all gone, not me. What was I supposed to do, say no?
Either that or make sure that I was dead.
Oh, no, no, no. No, please, please, listen, listen. Just decent thing would be to let a man get in a prayer before you kill him.
You can pray on the way up.
When I saw Richie Doucette hanging from that Ferris wheel, I felt a profound sense of disbelief. Nothing like this had ever happened before. You mobsters killed each other all the time, but it was generally a small, contained event. Some greaseball is eating spaghetti and meatballs at his favorite restaurant and gets popped in the head. But this was different. Even then, even before I knew who killed him, I knew that Richie had been put on display. Lincoln was trained in psychological warfare by the CIA. He wanted to terrify the mob, wanted them to know he was going to kill every last one of them, and that none of them would be able to stop him.
No to szukamy jakiegoś fury może, bo popłyniemy, co?
We're coming at you from deep inside the hollow. And tonight, we're gonna talk about the things happening right here in New Bordeaux. Things I don't think anyone could have ever predicted. Except your truth.
Nie ma ani jednego auta, kurde. Nie chcemy samego.
You got one thing to say to that boy. Don't stop till the ashes go cold. Don't stop until them bones are dust. Don't stop. Every last one of those motherfuckers is dead. If he is our wake-up call. Do you hear it? The Hollow does. When the Hollow speaks, you better listen.
Breaking news in New Bordeaux. There are reports of a violent shootout at the abandoned Baron Saturday's fun park. The authorities haven't released an official tally, but sources are reporting multiple casualties.
Can't get wet like this.
What are you saying? Needs one. Trzeba dzwonić, kurde. Gdzie jest...
This is your good friend Remy Duval, reminding y'all to tune in to Native Son.
Native Son!
On WBYU 620. Dear listener, this is your good friend Remy Duval, reminding y'all to tune in to Native Son.
Native Son!
On WBYU 620.
Seth's dead. The Hollow's yours.
They say you strung him up on the old Ferris wheel.
He killed Ellis. Shit all over the people in this neighborhood. Doucette got what he deserved.
The righteous will rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He will bathe his feet in the blood of the wicked. That goes both ways, you know.
You said all that was behind us.
My men are struggling with the notion that we now have to answer to the same men who killed Baca, who wiped out half our number.
If I was them, I'd get over it. We don't have time to go around coddling people.
Of course not. But gestures carry weight. And if you were to help my man Emmanuel, that's a gesture that would go a long way in calming nerves.
What's he need?
He oversees my reefer operation over at the boathouse. Help him, and I'll see to it you get a potion of the profits.
Just so we're clear, I'm expecting a cut of everything, not just what comes from selling weed. It's gonna cost a lot of money to take down Marcano.
Don't worry. I'll make sure you get your money.
Zobaczę, jakie są lepszenia. Zajdziemy do Emanuela. Zobaczymy, co ma to powiedzenie.
Come on!
Problems?
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to see the other briefings, we can get started.
Show me what else you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags. Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point for Dunn, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought it'd make things square with Sal, and he'd be able to get Point for Dunn back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah, just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point for Dunn. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.
To jedziemy porozmawiać z Berkiem. Ale jeszcze raz. Co to jest?
The man himself, Mr. Vito Scaletta.
You gotta be shitting me.
Last couple months have been pretty tough on old Vito. Sal's always hated him. Thought he was a mole for the commission, but he couldn't do anything about it because Vito's maid. After the heist, Sal refused to pay Vito his cut. And then he put the clamps on him. He's been trying to limit Vito's ability to pay what's owed.
And if Scaletta can't kick up, the commissioner gave Marcano permission to whack him.
The only reason that Vito is still above ground is because he has a couple off-the-record businesses. He's been using that money to pay Sal.
Gotta give Scaletta credit. Pretty goddamn tenacious.
He's lasted a lot longer than I thought he would, but the clock is ticking. A couple weeks ago, Sal sent in his nephew, a kid named Michael Greco, to help Vito run River Row. Greco's been using his guys to limit what Vito can do, where he can go. Once he has Vito completely boxed in, he'll make his move.
Scaletta has to know what Greco has planned. I'll pay him a visit. See if I can leverage this thing with Greco to bring Scaletta around in my way of thinking.
I'm sure I'll appreciate your concern.
Haven't the people down here heard about a little invention called air conditioning? Christ!
Gdzie to był robot? Gdzie to wyjść?
Any word about how it's going in there?
How do you think? Vito's taking his beating. Wish Greco would just let us kill the post some bitch and get it over with.
Nah, Greco wants to show how tough he is. Beat on old Vito till we all respect him.
You and me ain't getting paid enough to worry about Ride Walt.
Look, you hear that?
Run, rabbit, run!
There you are.
Winged him!
Swinging in trees, that true?
Under you, buddy.
Get that stupid son of a bitch!
Running out of fight here, boss.
Fucking dropping us!
Look who I found!
I'm fucking stuck!
Grabbing some cover!
Down.
Oh, shit! I'm pinned in! Hold it!
We got ourselves a guest! Gotta hunker down!
Get that stupid son of a bitch!
Fire it now!
I can't
move!
About how it's going in there?
How you think? Vito's taking his beating. Wish Greco would just let us kill the poor sumbitch and get it over with.
Nah, Greco wants to show how tough he is. Beat on old Vito till we all respect him.
If only all it took was beating up on a washed-up carpetbagger.
Huh? You cool.
Whatever.
Not sure what that was.
Hey! Hey!
Huh?
Get ready, boy! Running for
grace!
We got ourselves.
We've lost a gunfight!
He's
reloaded! Rush him!
I'm empty.
My dog's gonna land in your corpse. Gonna choke the life out of you.
Hide here. Kill one of our boys. That gun's mine. Nice piece of hardware.
You ain't that sly, dipshit.
This is the way you die!
Out of
give
ammo.
Me here! I got it!
Oh, motherfuckers die first!
There! Cut that sack of shit down!
We got our shot!
Nie jest łatwa, ale sprzątam.
Fuck, sucker! Take cover!
Looks like I got here just in time, Vito.
Lincoln. How's this possible? I thought you were dead.
Bullet was deflected by my skull. Came out the back.
Talk about some goddamn luck.
Worst place to shoot a fella's in the forehead. Skull's harder than you think. Come on. We need to have a talk.
When I heard about what happened, I went to Marcano asking my cut right then and there. I figured if he fucked you and Sammy, I'd be next.
Yeah, I'm guessing he didn't go for it.
Said he wanted to wait for the heat to die down. Didn't want me running around, buying expensive shit, getting noticed. Like I'm some fucking amateur, never sat on a big score before. That money I fronted for the robbery was pretty much everything I put away. Didn't have enough to run, so I stayed. Commission wouldn't let him just kill me, so I figure I'd make that cocksucker jump through every hoop, make him prove I deserve to get whacked. It wasn't much, but it was something.
Heard he brought in his nephew to push you out.
A kid named Michael Greco. Nephew by marriage, not blood.
Sure didn't number in here.
They were looking to see what other rackets I was running. Like I'd leave a fucking paper trail in my office. Eh, don't bother with that shit. Look, appreciate you getting me out of the freezer and all, but, what are you doing here?
Marcano deserves to pay for what he did, so I'm going after him. Him, his brothers, his lieutenants, all of them. And I'm gonna need your help.
Look. Pretty much whittle me down to nothing. I mean, this is it.
For now, maybe. Once I take back River Road from Greco, money will start coming in, it'll be a different story.
Also, we're partners now.
As long as you do what I say and give me what I want when I want.
So goodbye, Marcano, hello, Lincoln Clay.
It's either that or more of this. And next time, I won't be around to fish your ass out the freezer.
Nobody kills that scumbag but me.
You bring me Greco, I'm in.
Tell me about his rackets.
He took over the dock union and he's got a warehouse. He has a lot of valuable shit in there. You take both of them out, Greco's finished. A couple of my guys been keeping tabs on him. You should talk to them. They'll fill you in.
All right.
Out of me. With Greco around, ain't no one feeling real secure about that place, so we just keep back.
Dzisiaj to na tyle. Mam nadzieję, że się film będzie podobać. No i zapraszam na kolejny odcinek z Mafii 3. Trzymajcie się, na razie. Hej!